you a warrior for a reason. It's your calling. The only one that makes any sense. Every gate you open into darkness brings another challenge.
mind.
The journey to Helheim is never a straight one.
However you come to the gold-covered bridge that leads to Hell,
align yourself.
You may find it guarded by a giantess.
You will find yours.
She will ask your name. She will ask your lineage. She will ask your business. The Northmen tell of the warrior woman Brynhild, who leapt into fire and rode to Hell to join her slain love Sigurd, and is challenged by the giantess. Hela possesses large dwelling places in Helheim. Tall are her walls, high are her gates. The name of her dish is hunger. Her knife is famine. On her threshold all will stumble. Her bed is called sick bed, and her bed hangings are called flames of a funeral pyre. They say she is easy to recognize. Half black and half the color of flesh. And her face menacing and grim.
The gate is opening. Song again.
Is it?
Tell her.
Yes, the source of the darkness. It's coming. This is your moment.
I'm sorry. I can't watch this.
What are you doing? You're showing weakness. You're not a warrior, you're a disgrace. The gods will punish you for this. Pick up the sword, pick it up, fight the darkness, fight it. Get up. Get up. Get up and fight.
Hell is reaching deep inside of her. Stormy seas and lost souls. She's dreamt of this before. They say dreams are visions of our memories, thoughts, and fears, as seen by our inner eye. But what if each one of us is always dreaming, even when awake? And we only see what our inner eye creates for us. Is this what hell is? A world shaped by Senua's nightmares. Maybe that's why people feared seeing the world through her eyes. Because if you believe that Senua's reality is twisted, you must accept that yours might be too.
You failed the gods. You're pathetic. Rotten. Cursed. What were you thinking? Did you really think you could win? How stupid can you be? Everyone hates her. She's cursed.
The shadow hates.
Look at you. A warrior. Worthless, weak, pathetic. Go on, feel sorry for yourself, because there's no one left to do that for you.
Everywhere you failed. What's that?
Take it. If you're too much of a coward to fight, then end the suffering. Broken and lost. Just do like it, your sword.
Come on.
Why go on when you give everything and face that which torments you, only to find that it is worse than you could have imagined? Why go on? Is it really so weak to ask this? Or are we just so afraid of the honest answer that we do not dare pose the question? Sometimes the answer lies in a memory, a feeling, a song.
It's not real. It's a trick. It's not real. Listen to it.
Don't give up.
Who are you?
Do you still believe in me, Shadow?
No, it's not. It's a trick. It's a trick. He's already dead. He can't be here. It's impossible.
Tell him.
Come to me. Please.
Before she first met him, she was not in a good place. Just a teenager, but not like the others. Barely functioning, she rarely left the house. Her father, Zimbel, made sure of that. Only occasionally did she venture out on her own, collecting firewood and herbs. Errands out in the Orkney Plains. Was her world. Like this one. Barren. And lonely.
It's already disappeared. Nothing lives here, not even you. It's in your mind. You think you can see it, but it's in your mind.
He was. Where is he? The lone figure of a boy.
He's there, under the tree.
Swordplay under the shade of a tree. She remembers the first time she saw him. To her young eyes, he moved as if dancing.
Under the tree.
And the world danced with him. The gloom lifted. For the first time in years, she felt a ray of hope.
Deception.
How does he so effortlessly court the world and bliss? she could do the same. See the world through eyes anew. And dance with it. Just like he does.
What's your name?
Senua.
I haven't seen you before.
I don't leave home much.
Oh, Zeno's daughter.
I have to go.
Wait. Who taught you to fight like that?
No one.
No one?
Well, I watched you, and...
You learned all of that from watching me? You should become a warrior, you know.
Me?
I'm Dilly. I'm here for the warrior trials. Just come and watch. And bring your sword.
You can't put it into words. That moment when you look into the eyes of the one who is supposed to reassure you. Make you feel safe. It only takes an instant. Fear swallows you before you have a chance to make sense of it. And darkness becomes a part of who you are. But her world changed the day the Northman took him from her. Senua knows that there's no going back to how things were. That there's nothing to go back to at all.
Stay still, stay quiet, hide, don't tell her.
Their gods can see into your mind. They will use this power to destroy you.
They won't stop me. I can still feel him.
Whatever's left of him, they will never let him go.
I'm not gonna let him rot here!
You're the one rotting here.
Leave me alone.
You will die here.
No!
And all your suffering will have been for nothing!
Shut up!
Hero. His name is Sigmund. His father's hall was built around a great tree, and one day, Odin comes and thrusts a sword into the tree, a gift to whomever can release it. Many try, but the sword comes out of the sea. Death for Sigmund and his brothers seems certain, but the king's wife is Sigmund's sister, and she begs for mercy and implores the king to chain them up instead. He agrees.
It's coming from there. And there. What are they?
Look, we're
Its name is Gramr. It was forged by the god of all Northmen, Odin, and gifted to Sigmund, a great warrior.
I need this sword. It's important. Can you help me?
The sword appears whole, but it is an illusion. It shattered into shards long ago. It is said a great warrior can reforge Gramr by answering the trials of Odin, one for each shard. The roots of the Tree of Death will take you to new lands where you will face the trials.
Go to the shards. Go to the shard.
Go to the shards.
What's the shard? Find it.
It's the metal runestones.
It's in front of you.
Find it.
The metal.
The runes. You need that sword.
Go to the shard.
Find the shard.